Hey guys, what's going on? Bobby here, and welcome back to another race day vlog. We are here for round two of the Skip Barber Formula Race Series here at beautiful Virginia International Raceway. Practice number one, I was unable to get into the car due to unfortunate circumstances, but we made up for it in practice two with a third place time. We just went out for qualifying earlier today where I qualified sixth, but it's very tight in the field and there's definitely a lot of room for improvement and trying to climb back in the positions. We are moments away from getting in the car for race one, so looking forward to getting out there on the track and seeing how race one goes. This is Skip Barber Racing School. We teach the podium procedure. So you never come to the podium with your suit down.
What the heck, Bobby?
It's your first time, right?
No, it's not.
So we were going to put his picture in the thesaurus next to the word podium, but now I think we're not going to because you still don't know how. All right, guys. So Bobby, Mr. Podium, another podium, really great for the points. Is this your first time racing at VIR?
Yes, I've been on track here before for practicing, but I've never had a competition here, so really enjoyed it today. The track was phenomenal. Competitors were great to race with as well. I mean, that's to expected here in the Skip Barber Race Series, so it was a perfect race.
Some people say that VIR suits so many different types of cars. How do you think it suited the Skip Barber F4?
Oh, it's a perfect track for this formula car. You get to utilize a lot of the downforce and some of the high speed, high commitment corners. The S's is a perfect example for that. And the braking power that you feel going into turn one and down at the end of the back straightaway, I mean, it doesn't get any better than that.
So tell us about, you were hinting to me earlier before the podium that there was a certain three wide moment on the back straightaway, and you did what?
So I saw the guys in front of me. It was like lap one, and you can't win the race in lap one, right? Especially in turn one of lap one, but this was on the back straightaway and I saw him go three wide. I had a really good run, could have made it four wide, but I decided I was going to crack out of the throttle, say a prayer, set my GPS to the nearest church, and it was a little dicey. So fortunately everyone made it out of there all right and really put on a good show.
In the rest of the race,
there had to have been more moments of side by side. Tell us about at least one of those.
So I was getting a really good run on Mikkel, and I had a really good run heading up towards the S's, and I know that's not one of our prime passing opportunities, but the momentum was just good enough, and I knew that the level of racecraft that he has, that I knew I could race him that well, and decided to get to the inside. We went side by side through the first one, and I think he looked over and he's like, this man's crazy, and backed out, so I appreciate that, but just the level of respect and class that was shown out there with everyone that I was racing with was really good. And
Who would you like to thank?
First and foremost, Skip Barber Racing School, the DeMonte family, everything they do to enable all of us. You know, all of us young racers trying to get into the sport, it's very difficult to do. And with this Skip Barber Race Series, it's made very easy. You learn a lot of great skills. It's not just on the track, it's within marketing and being within this SRO group. It really puts you in the thick of things and really experience what racing's all about. And special shout out real quick, I've got my karting mentor here shooting video for me this weekend. He's working with an SRO team, so it's even more special to have him out here, and he helped me kind of get to this point too, and to have him out here in the crowd is pretty special as well.
Congrats again to Bobby Krug, who got third place overall with some patience and some intelligent driving. And he mentioned the hardship.
Built by Dingus. That's what I'm talking about.
Wow.
Skip Barber Formula Car Championship. It's been a long wait for this driver, and he's got a big fan base because he's so kind to others, takes care of others, does his best to promote the Skip Barber Formula Car Race Series. So this is a hard-earned and well-deserved victory for Bobby Krug! Right. Bobby, this has to feel amazing to you. It's been such a long wait. What was the emotion going through your mind when you had that slight edge of the finish line? Did you know that you had won?
I knew I had won. It took me a little bit to kind of process what had happened the lap before. I was watching Jeshua and Elvis go at it for those last couple laps, and I was just, I thought I had the best seat in the house and thought I was spectating at that point. So those two guys, very quick, very talented. You're going to expect a lot of really good things from them. I was just fortunate enough to take advantage of a little mistake by those guys. So once I came through, I got to turn one, and I was like, I just won my first ever race in a formula car, and just the emotions, I was mind blown, I was screaming, and some of it I probably shouldn't say on a PA system. But a lot of good things, you know, and it's like you said, it's been a long time coming. I'm very similar to Mikel over there, where he was saying that he comes from the karting background and not having money to do it. I was talking to somebody just a couple minutes ago, and I was mentioning that the best day of my life was winning a rental kart championship and getting to race a Briggs 206 go-kart, and now I'm sitting here at Virginia International Raceway, a winner in the Skip Barber Series that has, you know, educated some of the best racers in motorsports. And to be able to add my name to that list of legendary drivers, Perez, Alexander Rossi, yourself, all of our incredible instructors. I mean, even I go back to my first ever race and seeing how good Jeshua was at COTA in the rain, and I was never thinking that I was going to be able to compete with him for a win. So it's awesome.
That's the perfect finish. Who would you like to thank?
First and foremost, Skip Barber Racing School, the DeMonte family for everything they do, to be able to give young up-and-coming racers an opportunity to be able to prove themselves on this platform, with this SRO group also as a good backdrop to get this professional experience. Got to thank my parents back at home, all the people at St. Louis and the karting community that helped get me to this point. And obviously everyone here that's still around supporting, and all the family and parents of these racers that build this family that we have here. It's more than a race series. Like everything else that was going on this weekend, we're a race family. So really happy to be a part of that.
Thank you so much. Congrats again to Bobby Krug. One more time, your top three, Mikel Gade, Joshua Lionel, and Bobby Krug.
All right.
All right, it's time for everyone's favorite part of the day. Greg soundbites. Greg, podium soundbites here.
Hey, Bobby, are you even old enough to drink yet? Bobby, that's a good job today. Darn near got boot scooted at the line, but you managed to pull her off. I don't know if to put a transponder on the end of your.
It's a good thing you learned in go-karting. You was a little bit at the line there, and.
Well, is this a proud dad moment right here?
I don't know.
Get emotional on me. Cry a little bit.
See, the thing is, Bobby was adopted, so me and his mother, we don't have an emotional connection. We did it for the tax cuts.
Also, Dale is still missing, so if anyone's found Dale, there is a prize reward.
Red alert. Dale.
We haven't found him in Virginia. We're going to Watkins Glen, New York next. Maybe we'll find him there.
Listen, we've been looking for Dale. We've hit a bit of a wall in our search.